identifying heavy and light objects.
Hello children, I am the parrot. Welcome to this video. Let's see what we will learn in this video. Identifying heavy and light objects. Today Chotu and his mother have come to play in the park. Chotu wants to play on the seesaw.
Mummy, come on, let's play on it.
As soon as Chotu's mother sits on the seesaw, after Chotu, the seesaw tilts down on her side.
Mummy, why has the seesaw gone down on your side?
Chotu, I'm heavier than you, so this seesaw has gone down on my side. And you are lighter than me, so the seesaw is in the air on your side.
Really, Mummy? Now I understood.
So children, did you see? Mother was heavier than Chotu, so the seesaw went down on her side. And Chotu was lighter than his mother, so the seesaw was in the air on Chotu's side. Today Chotu played a lot in the park and he was hungry after getting back from the park.
Mummy, I'm very hungry. Please give me something to eat.
Chotu, there is an apple and a watermelon in the kitchen. Go and get it.
Chotu picks up the apple from the kitchen and brings it out.
Take this apple, Mummy. Now I will bring watermelon.
Chotu goes to the kitchen to get watermelon. And Chotu tries to lift the watermelon. But he was not able to lift it. Chotu goes to his mother.
Mummy, I'm not able to lift the watermelon.
It's okay, Chotu. The apple is lighter than watermelon, so you picked it up. But the watermelon is heavier than the apple. That's why you couldn't pick it.
Okay, Mummy.
So, children, did you see? Chotu could pick up the apple because the apple was light. But he couldn't lift the watermelon because it was heavy. This means all objects have some weight. Some are light and some are heavy. So children, that was all for today. In this video, we learned identifying heavy and light objects. In the next video, we will learn how to identify the heaviest and the lightest objects. Till then, bye children.
Identifying the heaviest and lightest objects.
Hello children, in the previous video we learned how to identify heavy and light objects. In this video we will learn how to identify the heaviest and lightest objects. Today Chotu has to water the plants. Chotu is filling water in the bucket to water the plants. After filling the bucket, Chotu wanted to lift the bucket, but Chotu was not able to lift it.
I'm not able to lift the bucket. What do I do now? Let me ask Pinky. Pinky, I'm not able to lift the bucket of water. Now how do I water the plants?
Chotu, the bucket of water is heavy. You will not be able to lift it up. You can get water in a jug.
Okay, Pinky.
This time, Chotu fills the jug and goes to water the plants. Chotu picked up the jug filled with water, but on his way to water the plant, the jug fell off his hand.
Oh, Chotu, what happened?
Mummy, I want to water the plants, but this jug fell off my hand.
Chotu, this water jug is heavy for you. Do one thing. You fill the mug with water.
Sure, Mummy.
This time, Choto fills the mug with water. And he waters the plants. In this way, Choto was able to give water to all the plants. So, children, can you tell me which is the heaviest object among these three? Yes, the bucket of water is the heaviest among these. And which is the lightest object among them? Your answer is right, children. The mug is the lightest among them. Some objects are kept here. A handkerchief, a bed sheet, and a mattress. Children, can you tell me which of these three objects is the heaviest and which is the lightest one? Yes, the mattress is the heaviest. And the handkerchief is the lightest. Was your answer the same, children? It seems you have learned to recognize the lightest and heaviest objects. So, children, in this video, we learned how to identify the heaviest and the lightest objects. In the next video, we will see some common mistakes in identifying heavy and light objects, which should be avoided. Till then, bye, children.
Common mistakes in identifying heavy and light objects.
Hello, children. In the previous video, we identified the heaviest and the lightest objects. In this video, we will see some common mistakes in identifying heavy and light objects. Today, Choto's uncle and aunt have come to his house. Along with them is their little child Chinu, with whom Choto is going to have a lot of fun.
Mummy, can I go and play with Chinu?
Yes, Choto, you can go.
Choto brings a balloon and his ball to play with Chinu. Choto and Chinu first play with the balloon.
Hold this, Chinu. Catch!
Chinu holds the balloon. After some time, both of them started playing with the ball. But Chinu is unable to play. He misses the ball every time. So children, do you know why this is happening every time? That Chinu can hold the balloon very well but cannot catch the ball at all? Yes, you thought it right. The ball is heavier than the balloon. Chinu cannot catch the ball. And the balloon is lighter than the ball. Children, but Choto cannot understand what happened. The size of the ball and the balloon are the same. But still, how did the ball become heavier than the balloon? This shows that it is not always necessary that the object that looks the same should be of the same weight. Did you see, children? The balloon was light, so Chinu lifted the balloon. But the ball was heavy. That's why Chinu was not able to pick it up. Today is Pinky's birthday. Choto goes to a shop to buy a toy for Pinky along with his mother. They saw a teddy bear at the shop.
Choto, let's give this teddy bear to Pinky.
No, Mummy. Let's give this piggy bank. Since this teddy bear is very big, it will be heavy. Hence, Pinky will not be able to lift it.
Choto, do one thing. You just try picking them.
Okay, Mummy.
Choto tries to pick up the piggy bank, but he is not able to do that.
Mummy, this piggy bank is very heavy. I'm unable to lift it.
Yes, Chotu, this piggy bank is heavy. Come on, now try picking this teddy bear.
Chotu picked up the teddy bear and he lifted it easily. Children, can you tell how Chotu picked up such a huge teddy bear? Yes, piggy bank was heavy. Chotu could not lift it. And teddy bear was very light. Chotu picked it up very easily.
So did you see, Chotu? Objects that look big in size need not always be the heavy.
Yes, Mummy. We will give this teddy bear to Pinky. She'll be really happy.
So children, this means that objects which look big are not always heavy. And objects which look small are not always light. That was all for today. In this video, we learned about some common mistakes in identifying heavy and light objects. I hope you have understood this topic properly. Bye, children.
Examples of long and short objects. Kids, in the previous video, you learned how to identify the long object and the short object out of two objects. In this video, we will identify the longest object and the shortest object out of three objects. Today is a school holiday for Chotu and Pinky. They are both sitting outside their house and playing with their toy cars.
Chotu, can you tell me, out of all these cars that are kept here, which one is the longest out of these?
This car is the longest, isn't it, Pinky?
Yes, Chotu. Out of these three cars, this one is the longest car. And out of these, which is the shortest car, Chotu?
This car is the shortest, right?
Yes, Chotu, you are absolutely right. Out of these three cars, this one is the longest car and this is the shortest car. See, over there, Papa's, Mummy's and your slippers are kept. Can you tell me, out of these three, whose slippers are the longest?
Yes, Pinky. Papa's slippers are the longest.
Yes, Chotu. And out of these three, whose slippers are the shortest?
My slippers are the shortest, Pinky.
Yes, Chotu. You're absolutely right. This means that out of the three slippers, Papa has the longest slippers and you have the shortest slippers. Come on, now let's play, Chotu.
So kids, now you can also identify the longest object and the shortest object out of three objects like Chotu. Come, let's see. These are three chocolates. Can you tell me which is the longest chocolate out of these? Yes, this chocolate is the longest. And which is the shortest chocolate out of these three? Yes, this chocolate is the shortest. This means that out of these three chocolates, this is the longest chocolate and this is the shortest chocolate. That is all for today. In this video, we identified the longest object and the shortest objects out of three objects. So in the next video, we will see some common mistakes in identifying long and short objects. Till then, bye-bye, friends! common mistakes in identification of long and short objects. So kids, in the previous video, you identified the longest object and the shortest object out of three objects. So friends, in this video, we will learn about some common mistakes in identifying long and short objects. Chotu and his mother have sat down to have their food. Chotu, can you please give me a spoon, please?
Which spoon, mummy? The short one or the long one?
Chotu, both these spoons are of the same length. Neither of them is short or long.
No, mummy. See, this spoon is long and this spoon is short.
Oh no, Chotu. This spoon looks longer to you because it is placed a little ahead. Keep both the spoons together so that one end of both the spoons is together.
Okay, mummy. Here you go.
Now tell me, out of these two spoons, is either of them long or short? Or both the spoons are of the same length, tell me?
Oh yes, mummy. Both of them are of the same length. Understood.
Now, see the three keys kept near you, Chotu. One is my room key, one is your room key, and one is the house key. Now can you tell me, Chotu, which of the three keys is the longest key and which key is the shortest key?
By looking at them, it seems like this key is the longest and this key is the shortest. But before answering your question, mummy, I will keep all the three keys together so that one end of all the three keys is together.
Okay, Chotu, now tell me.
Now, if we look at all the three keys, the length of all three is the same. That's why neither of them is long or short. Isn't it, mummy?
Yes, Chotu. Very good. So, kids, now you also won't make a mistake in comparing the length of two or more objects like Chotu, right, friends? Always remember that before comparing the length of objects, first, we should keep the objects together so that one end of all the objects is together, and then the lengths of these objects should be compared. That's all for today. In these videos, we learned how to compare the length of two or more objects. I hope that you have understood this topic very well, friends. Bye-bye.
Identifying tall and short objects.
Hello children, I'm the parrot and I welcome you to this lesson. Today in this video, we will learn identifying the taller and shorter between two given objects. Today is a holiday for Chotu and Pinky. They have come to the zoo with their mother. They saw several animals there. First of all, they saw some elephants.
Mummy, look how tall this elephant is. Very tall.
And how short is this elephant, Pinky? It seems that this shorter elephant is the child of this taller elephant.
Yes, children, you are right. This elephant is taller and this elephant is shorter.
After this, Chotu, Pinky and their mother saw some giraffes.
Mummy, how short this giraffe is?
And this giraffe is taller than this one.
Yes, children. Out of these two giraffes, this is shorter and this one is taller.
So, children, did you see? How Chotu and Pinky identified the taller elephant, the shorter elephant, and the taller giraffe and the shorter giraffe. So can you tell me which of these two trees is taller and which one is shorter tree? Yes, this tree is taller and this tree is shorter. And out of these two ladders, this ladder is taller and this ladder is shorter. So children, I hope that you enjoyed identifying and comparing taller and shorter objects. Now you can identify the tall and short objects around you and compare them to tell which is taller and which one is shorter. That's all for today, children. In this video, we learned to identify taller and shorter objects between two objects. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples of identifying the tallest and shortest of three objects. Till then, bye children.
Identifying the tallest and shortest objects.
Children, in the previous video, we learned to identify taller and shorter objects between two objects. In this video, we will identify the tallest and the shortest of three objects. Today, Pinky and Chotu are coming back from school together.
Chotu, just see, these buildings are so tall.
Yes, Pinky, look how tall this yellow building is.
Yes, Chotu, look, this blue building is even taller than the yellow.
Yes, Pinky, this blue building is taller than the yellow building.
Hey, Chotu, just look. This glass building is taller than these two.
Yes, Pinky, that glass house is the tallest among all these houses.
So this means that the yellow house is the shortest of the three houses.
So can you see, children? Yellow house is the shortest and the glass house is the tallest of all the three houses. After going a while, Pinky and Chotu passed by Sonu's house. They saw Sonu playing with blocks in the courtyard of his house. Sonu is building a house with his blocks.
Come on, Chotu, let's join Sonu.
Pinky and Chotu went to Sonu. Three friends started building different houses using the blocks. Sonu, Pinky and Chotu's block houses are ready. So children, can you tell me who has made the tallest block house? You are right, children. Pinky's block house is the tallest among these three houses. Children, can you tell me whose block house is the shortest of all? Yes, Chotu's block house is the shortest of these three. Could you guess the correct answer, children? This shows that out of these three houses, Pinky's house is the tallest and Chotu's house is the shortest. So children, in this video, we learned to identify the tallest and the shortest of three given objects. In the next video, we will see examples of identifying the tall and short objects. Until then, bye children.
examples of identifying tall and short objects.
So children, in the last video, we identified the tallest and the shortest of the three objects. In this video, we will see examples of identifying tall and short objects. Today, Chotu, Aarti and Sonu have come to fly kites in the park.
Today, my kite will fly the highest.
Okay, let's see.
When three of them were flying kites, Chotu said that time,
"Look, my kite is flying high."
Okay, now I will fly my kite higher than your kite.
Sonu was silently flying his kite, and his kite started flying high.
Wow, Sonu, your kite is flying the highest of all three of us.
So children, did you see how Aarti, Sonu and Chotu flew their kites? Let's see what happened after that. Chotu and Aarti were going home together after flying their kites. While going home, they saw an uncle on the way.
Chotu, look how tall that uncle is.
Yes, Aarti, you are right. This uncle is much taller than both of us.
So children, did you see? Chotu and Aarti saw an uncle taller than both of them. After walking a little further, Chotu and Aarti saw two electric poles. These are the two poles. So children, can you tell me which one of these two electric poles, which one is taller and which one is shorter? Yes, this pole is taller and this one is the shorter one. That's all for today. In these videos, we learned to compare the height of two and three objects. I hope you have understood this topic very well. Bye, children.
Identifying thick and thin objects.
Hello children, I am the parrot. Welcome to this video. Let's see what we will learn in this video. Identifying thick and thin objects. And identifying the thickest and the thinnest objects. This evening there is no electricity in Chotu's and Pinky's house. Mother has asked Chotu and Pinky to bring a thick candle from the market. Chotu and Pinky went to a shop to buy candles.
Auntie, please give a thick candle.
Take this, children. Choose out of this.
Chotu, can you tell me which of these is a thicker candle?
Children, can you tell me which of these candles is thick and which one is thin? Well done, children. Amongst these two candles, this one is thicker and this candle is the thinner one.
Pinky, this candle is thick and this candle is thin.
Okay. Chotu, will this thick candle burn all night?
Pinky, let's take a candle thicker than this.
Right, Chotu. Let's take a candle thicker than this. Auntie, please give us the thickest candle.
Here you go, children. This is the thickest candle.
Pinky, this candle is the thickest. Let us take this.
Okay, Chotu.
Children, Pinky and Chotu took the thickest candle. Can you tell me which of the three candles is the thinnest one? Yes, this is the thinnest candle. Was your answer the same, children? So, children, today Chotu and Pinky identified the thickest and thinnest candle. The next day when the electricity went off, Chotu and Pinky went to play in the park. They were playing hide and seek. First, it was Chotu's turn to hide. Chotu decided to hide behind a tree. Chotu saw two trees in the front. So, children, can you tell me behind which tree Chotu should hide? This tree is thin, so Chotu cannot hide behind this. Chotu goes and hides behind another tree. Do you know why Chotu is not seen now? You are right, children. This tree is thick, so he can easily hide behind it. That's why Chotu chose to hide behind this thick tree. So, children, did you see? Chotu could not hide behind the thin tree, but could easily hide behind a thick tree. So, children, that was all for today. In this video, we learned identifying thick and thin objects and identifying thickest and thinnest objects. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples of identifying thick and thin objects. Till then, bye children.
Examples of identifying thick and thin objects.
Hello children. In the previous video, we saw identifying thick and thin objects and identifying the thickest and thinnest objects. In this video, we will see some interesting examples of identifying thick and thin objects. Chotu and Pinky want to have a swing on the tree behind their house.
Pinky, what all do we need to make a swing on the tree?
A piece of wood and a rope. That's it.
A piece of wood is right here.
Yes, Chotu. Let's get the rope from Mummy.
Pinky and Chotu went to get the rope from Mummy.
Mummy, we need a rope to make a swing.
Okay, Chotu. There are two ropes inside. Go and get them.
Okay, Mummy.
Chotu brings both the ropes from inside.
Here are the ropes.
Come on, let us take a rope for the swing. This rope is very beautiful.
Yes, let's take this one.
Children, this rope is thin. If you make a swing with it, the swing will break as soon as you sit on it.
Really, Mummy? What should we do now?
Children, you should make a swing with this thick rope. It won't break when you sit.
Children, do you think this rope is thicker than the previous rope?
Pinky, we will make swing with the rope because this rope is thicker than this rope.
Well done, children. You were right. Come on. Let me help you to hang this swing.
After hanging the swing, Chotu and Pinky swung a lot and had fun. So children, you saw Chotu and Pinky chose the thick rope instead of the thin rope to hang a swing. So children, can you identify thick and thin pencil from these two pencils? Yes, this is thick pencil and this is thin pencil. So children, that's all for today. In this video, we saw some interesting examples of identifying thick and thin objects. In the next video, we will see some interesting examples of identifying the thickest and the thinnest objects. Till then, bye children.
Identifying the thickest and thinnest objects.
So children, in the previous video, we saw some interesting examples of identifying thick and thin objects. In this video, we will see some interesting examples of identifying the thickest and thinnest objects. Today, Choto is doing his drawing homework. Choto has taken colors, a large piece of paper and few brushes to paint.
Choto, what are you painting?
Pinky, I have thought of making a plant in an open field today.
Choto picks up a brush and starts making green field. But Choto's brush is making a very thin line and Choto is taking a lot of time to cover the green field.
Oh Choto, your brush is very thin. It will take a lot of time to color the field with such a thin brush.
So what should I do, Pinky?
Choto, if you take the thickest brush, then you'll be able to paint the entire field very quickly.
Okay, all right, Pinky. But which of these is the thickest brush?
So children, can you identify the thickest brush amongst these three brushes? You are absolutely right, children. This brush is the thickest of these three brushes.
Yes, this brush is the thickest. Let me use this to color the field. Oh, wow, Pinky. I was able to color the field quickly using the thickest brush. Yes, but this thick brush cannot be used to make the plant.
Yes, you are right, Choto. So you can take the thinnest brush to make the plant.
Yes, it will be easy to color the plant with a thin brush. But which is the thinnest brush, Pinky?
Children, can you tell me which of these three brushes is the thinnest brush? You are absolutely right, children. This is the thinnest brush.
Here it is, Choto, the thinnest brush.
Choto finishes his painting quickly. So children, did you see that Choto used the thickest brush to paint the green field and the thinnest brush to paint the plant? So children, can you tell me that which of these three books is the thickest book of all? This is the thickest book and this is the thinnest book. That's all for today. In this video, we saw some interesting examples of identifying the thickest and the thinnest objects. I hope you have understood this topic properly. Bye, children.